Hello everyone, this is Minecraft Alex here, and welcome to episode 19 of Minecraft Vanilla Superflat Survival. And now I'm going to show you the achievements that I've made in the last, off-camera. So, I have actually made quite a bit of achievements off-camera. I have actually finally discovered a nether fortress, which is really amazing because we can now finally fight some blazes, get wither skeleton skulls, and awesome stuff like that. I can also kill off some blazes and stuff like that, and of course I can make that potion stand that I've been wanting to make for a very long time in Superflat. Now, I already marked off the area where I have to go to get to the nether fortress. However, I will take this wool and I will mark out the area because I haven't really marked out the whole area. I have only marked out the area using torches. But I guess my protocol. Oh, let's hope we get. Please, redstone. Please, please, please. Oh, we got some sugar. It's not bad, but it's not good. Also, some of my most, viewers who notice the most things will notice that I actually have a bit more redstone than I did in the last episode, and the reason is because I have actually gotten some more redstone from a witch. I think I got like 2 or 3 redstone from one drop, I kind of forgot, but that brings us a bit closer to actually making a an automatic AFK cobblestone generator without the use of coppers, which of course I have a tutorial for in my on my channel page. And now that we have 6 redstone, and I need 9 redstone to make such an automatic cobblestone generator, I only need 2 more redstone to complete that, so hopefully I might trade or do something like that to get more redstone. Or I could just get it from that village right here that just spawned here. Yes! One more piece of redstone, but we're still short. Well, I did not expect that we were gonna get 3 redstone from a witch, and I doubt that's even possible, but we are much closer to getting enough redstone for our amazing grinder. Cobblestone generator. And I have actually had some issues with slime spawning on my property, which is kind of weird because I didn't expect that they would start spawning on my, in my enclosed area because I haven't had any issues with them before. I actually think that they somehow glitch through the walls or something because I have actually been hit by a giant slime while standing on the other side of the wall. They are quite glitchy, or maybe we just have like 1 or 2 blocks right here that are inside a slime chunk and they just never really had the chance to spawn. But nevertheless, we are kind of having issues with slime, so I'll have to look into that and go into my F3 inventory and make sure to look at all the chunks just to make sure and look at the areas where they're spawning the most or appearing the most, at least I might say, because they might not be spawning, they might be just glitching through the walls. So now I'm gonna go to the nether and gonna go into that nether fortress. I haven't actually gotten the chance to really explore the nether fortress yet. I think I should get, yes, I'm gonna fix my bow. It's kinda half, it's kinda a bit broken, so I'm gonna take the bow that I got from a rare skeleton drop and craft it in with my current bow to make it a really, like, a bow with lots of durability. And also, sometimes 2 stacks of arrows may not be enough, so I'll take 3 just in case. Because I really love shooting ghasts and, all of those zombie pigment and everything, which is great. And of course, the zombie pigment do give me gold. Okay, let me just extinguish that real quick. The zombie pigment do give me gold nuggets, so that's great. I have so far gotten 8 gold nuggets. That's not enough for even 1 gold ingot, because I would need 1 more, because 9 gold nuggets equals 1 gold ingot. Even though the zombie pigment give you gold, it's very difficult to get large amounts of gold unless you have an efficient farm. But in Skyblock, I was able to actually get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I was actually able to get 14 gold ingots just from killing, manually killing zombie pigmen in the nether. And that is because I was able to heal 2 villagers in my Skyblock world, and to do that, I must either create a farm in the nether, which is very difficult, and I did not do that, or just manually kill off enough zombie pigmen to get that. So, let me go into statistics real quick and see how much zombie pigmen I actually killed. I'm just really interested in this. Let's see. Yes, I killed 11 zombie pigmen. So, for the 11 zombie pigmen I killed, I did not even get... Oh, crap. Get off from there. So, from the, the 11 zombie pigmen that I killed, I did not even get one, I did not even get one gold ingot, so, you know, go figure, that's extremely low rates. Now let me put on my armor real quick here. I don't think, also from I'll just go and run back real quick. This armor I actually got from loot from chests from just the villages that I explored and from the blacksmith's chests. Now I did get a very rare drop from a zombie. I actually got iron boots with protection 1, and they're actually fairly, I wouldn't really say that they're about to break. It actually has a very high durability level. That chance is like 1 in a million. I don't think I ever got such good boots, iron boots, with such a high durability level just from zombies themselves. So, yeah. And that. And now I'm going to go into the nether real quick. And then now we're going to go and explore that nether fortress. I have not actually explored it. And I have not actually collected anything from it. I kind of tunneled up to it. But other than that, I did not do anything. So, let's go. Another thing that you might notice that I did is I actually kind of, oh crap, I actually kind of mined out these two blocks up here and then two blocks up here, is because the reason I did that is because when I was spawning in the nether portal, I would get a half a heart of suffocation damage because there was solid blocks here, and I decided just to, oh darn, didn't want to place that, and I just decided to break these blocks here, and apparently there were blocks up there anyway, so that was a good decision. I also have one gas tier, and I have also crafted a ton of torches just in case. I have collected quite a bit of glowstone dust, and then this is all of the nether brick that I use tunneling up, so. Yeah, that's that. And this is exactly where my nether fortress is that I found. Oh yes, there it is, so. I'm going to be marking these areas out with wool blocks, and my protocol for finding nether fortresses will be that I will, when I explore, I will place torches, and torches basically just mean that I've been here, and it doesn't mean that there's anything interesting here, but if I start placing a wool, then that means that I have found something interesting, such as a nether fortress, or something like that, so, wool in this case will denote that I did find a nether fortress, so it will be easier to distinguish the roots of nether fortresses rather after just regular roots, so I'm gonna pile up like that. One issue with using wool, though, is that the ghasts would kind of start shooting at me, and the wool would start catching fire, so that was a bit negative side of that, and if a netherrack block adjacent to the wool caught fire, the wool would burn down very quickly. So that's the minus side of that. So I do not really mind much. I don't really mind much of the nether quartz that I find because I don't really see a use for it. And I do not really need nether quartz as of now. So let me see. Is this really the correct place? Yes, this looks like the correct area. So, yep. This is, we're heading on our way to the nether fortress. So now let me pile up a bit more right here. Just to make sure, okay, we hear some gas, but I don't think there's any gas here. Let me try to extinguish some of the fire here. I don't see any gas here, I think it's up there or somewhere there, so. Yeah. And also, especially near such exits, I like to place torches and place some wool up here just so it'd be easy to denote where the entrances are. This is a tunnel that I decided to go through, and I saw all these huge lava lakes, and I decided to go through here because in my opinion, well, at least in my experience of finding nether fortresses, they usually spawn on top of large areas of lava, so that's where I'm kind of gravitating towards. I placed some blocks up here just so I would not accidentally fall down, and that would suck. And the reason is because I kind of mined down to see if there's land under there. Yep. So, okay, let me just mine that just so it make it easier to jump down. And then I went through this cave right here. I did not go up here. Oh, yes, I did go up here and collect some glowstone. It's going to be difficult to collect this glowstone here because there's nothing under it to collect it, so I'm not going to break it. I might collect the glowstone down there near my little tunnel area. Only if I'm low on glowstone, but I don't think I will because most of my glowstone will be obtained from villager trading, so that's gonna get handled. Okay, now you place some more wool right here. Okay, let's hope that there's not much gas here, because they do kind of start to destroy most of my wool block structure, so let me pile up right here. Yes, and I do have quite a bit of dangerous bridges here, and in my Skyblock series, I did not really make much really far away bridges, and I think that the reason that I started making these far off bridges is that I have now started to find more nether fortresses, because I have to go around these really large lava lakes. But before, I avoided these large lava lakes, but now I understand that to find a nether fortress, I have to gravitate toward these lava lakes and not go inside caves, because I have a much more larger chance of finding a nether fortress in a big open space like this, especially with lava lakes and lava oceans, than just a small enclosed cave. However, I think I did find a nether fortress once through just going through caves, and that's just because I had an exit to it. Okay, where is this ghast? Can't really see one as of now. I don't really need much wool markers here, because the bridge is very visible itself, so... Now, I don't really like all the fire here, but I don't really have time to extinguish all of it. My most important thing would be to actually go around here and place some wool blocks here, just so I could see where the entrance is to the little staircases, and I just use the staircase to get up. Okay, there's... I can see a ghast. Okay. Okay, let's... Okay, now I have to... I don't hit the ghast very often, but I should hit it fairly soon. Oh, yes, I hit it right there. Okay, that should knock it. Oh, no. Couldn't get that one. Okay. Now, the next time I hit it, it should die. So, okay, it keeps on flying sideways, so I can't really hit it with its own... Not very easy. I used to be a better at this, but now I kind of suck at this. Well, I think it kind of flew a bit too far for that. Now I think the best thing I could do now is just simply avoid it. And what really sucks is the netherrack is so sensitive to ghast fireballs, so it just it gets basically destroyed very often. So that's not a good thing. Now in this area right here, I did not have any time to put up any more. Any more wool to denote the areas. Okay. Like I said before, it just completely knocked out my whole area, so... Okay, finally, I killed a ghast. Okay, let's hope that it died. Oh, wow, it did not actually burn up the wool. It actually dropped as an item, so that's weird. Okay, now let's hope that the ghast actually died under some... not under lava, but under some blocks, because that way I could get some ghast tears out of him, and those are pretty useful for potion of regeneration, as most of us know. Now the reason I'm doing this is just so I can have faster access to the... Okay, where? Oh, okay, so there's apparently one up there. Those are not very easy to kill. Okay, okay, oh, yes. Oh, I have CXP falling down. This is going to be so good. Okay, now I'm going to place some torches here just to denote that I've already been here, just in case. I don't know if... Can I place torches? Oh, yeah, I can place torches on Soul Sand. I didn't know that. Is that... Oh, yes. Oh, baby, a triple. We got a ghast tier. That's nice. It's going to be useful for a potion of regeneration sometime in the future. Well, at least we got something from killing all of those ghasts. Okay, now let me see. I don't really want to use cobblestone too much. It's a very valuable resource for me, and I don't really want to waste it, but in the nether, it's something that cannot be replaced with anything else. I mean, I can actually build a mob grinder using netherrack in the overworld, but I cannot do that in the nether because the ghast fireballs just all destroyed, so... This totally beats going around and having to go down right here. That way I can just run around this area right here. And I will try to make it as easy as possible to get to and from the nether fortress, because I will be going back and forth very often. I have to make sure I have all of these good structures that denote exactly where am I supposed to go. Okay, did a ghast die here too? Oh, this is where the other ghast died too. Wow, it did not even drop any gunpowder. That's a pity. Well, I do not really need any gunpowder, so I would not really say that I wanted to drop gunpowder because it's kind of useless for me. I don't have, can't make TNT out of that. Can't really do anything with it. And I've already marked out some of the wool right here as I was going back home, but then I ran out of wool, so I decided to take some more wool with me, and when I go this way, I'll put more wool blocks, so now I put up all the wool blocks that I need to. Now I have another bridge here, kind of going into this staircase right here. I think that I can make a more fissured route, because this route kind of does kind of go... It's not really straight, because I can make a straight route, but this one is not straight just because of the way I was exploring it. Okay, I have another bridge right here. This does have quite a bit of bridges going over lava lakes, because I'm trying to reach those really, really large lava lakes, like such as this one. Oh, I was just worrying. I thought that series of white wool there, that I mistook that for a ghast once. So that was weird. Okay, now let me just place one right here. Now right here, I have a tunnel right here, and wow. A pigment managed to spawn there. And also, there are these weird lighting glitches within the lava here. And this area used to be kind of... Let me show you. This area used to be... The reason there's this huge lava waterfall is because I somehow managed... I think a ghast shot some netherrack, it got destroyed, and the lava started flowing down like that. And then the lava almost flooded this tunnel right here, so... Right here, if I break these blocks, there's gonna be lava flowing through here, so that's not good. And I decided to cover it up, and I had to cover it up before the lava could flood the tunnel, and I was able to do that. So I also leave some geographical markers right here, which is the wool right here, to make sure that I'm going in the correct direction, just in case if I want to branch out the tunnel, just so I know exactly where I'm going. Okay, now looks like I think I should place some wool right here, just in case. I still have a ton of wool, and I don't really need it that much. Well, except for carpet, but I'm not really a big fan of carpet, so... And this is our nether... And this is, ladies and gentlemen, our nether fortress. Okay, now let me just take that real quick. Which is extremely epic, because we can now get blazes and stuff. Actually, one thing that I have to do now that I've discovered a nether fortress is set up a really kind of a small base, kind of like a small area of operations or a small base within this area right here. That was so scary. Now, I really do have to watch out for stuff like that, because you don't get much second chances in the nether. The lava would have destroyed all my items if I would fall into the lava. Yeah, I really should watch out for stuff like that, so... And of course, there's the ghast flying around that can destroy me in seconds. Okay. I'll probably build a house, which is gonna be something like... 5x5, or a small base somewhere around here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4... Okay, well, then it's gonna be like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, and it's gonna have a 3x3 inner area right here. And that's where I'm gonna store my most valuable belongings when I get the loot, and I can come back, place some stuff in my chest, and then go back there. That way I can get some... That I can efficiently place the loot around. Now, I really should have taken some provisions with me, because, like, I do not want to craft more doors right now, because that way it would, it's gonna be kind of a waste of wood. Okay, I apparently fell down again. That kinda, I did not really notice that, but yeah. Like I said, it's going to be kind of a waste of wood if I craft more chests, because I have a ton of useless chests lying around at my base in the overworld. So I'm thinking about going back to the overworld just for chests and doors. But on the other hand, it would be much less hassle-free if I would go to go and craft some more doors and chests. Okay, this pigment has to go. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna craft the doors and chests right here on site, because I do not really want to run there back and forth. And it's not really efficient either, so... And I am putting cobblestone all around this area right here, just so I can have a platform, just in case of the ghasts start spazzing out and destroying everything. Okay, now we're down to a stack, which is a bit worrying. Okay, let's hope that there's some floor under there. Let me just break that up. This is going to be my mini base of operations, like I said before, for my... And this is the reason why I put cobblestone all around the areas right here. And I can't even see where I'm being shot from. So, go figure. Oh, crap. Oh, that was so close. Oh, yes! Okay, did we get anything? Aw, we only got gunpowder. But, okay, well, at least we got that little piece of XP. Okay, I do not want all this fire around my house. Okay, now there's kind of a hole right there, so... I think I'll just continue going like this. And try to save on cobble without placing it on other areas where there needs to be no cobblestone. And this cobblestone is going to be my little platform that's going to be gassed indestructible, just in case. I will still place some ladders up here, just in case if I ever need to get up here or something like that. Okay, now we have... Now when we have that set up... Oh yes, of course, we don't have the roof on yet, which is probably the most important part. So now this is a completely... This base is officially safe from ghast attacks, so... Actually, on the other hand, what I think I'll do is I'll grab some loot from over there and then come home. Then grab some doors and stuff like that, and then come back here and then place all of that there, so... Actually, no, on the other hand, it's very easy to craft crafting tables and stuff like that. I should not worry about that, so... Okay, now I'm gonna craft... a double chest real quick right here. Place them right over here. I might have a brewing stand somewhere here. I think, yes, there's gonna be some. And this is exactly the reason why I have such houses and bases, because there's a ton of mobs here. So I'll have a door right here and a door right here. I also might add a second chest here, or just a furnace, or maybe a little brewing stand if I decide that I need potion brewing here. So let me just put down some gas tiers here. Set down probably most of the torches. Actually, no, I'll take the torches with me. Set down the wool. I won't need wool. But on the other hand, I do need to mark out. Okay, then I'll definitely not need ladders. No, I'm pretty sure that I need most of the stuff there. Yeah, that's not really working out. Oh, wait. Oh, I just realized that ghasts can destroy nether brick. I wonder if that's true or not. Oh, darn. Okay, it should die now. Okay, there's a ton of ghasts spawning, and I don't know why. Well, I think it's obviously because I'm on hard mode. That definitely spawns more ghasts. Oh, actually, I think I read somewhere that putting the game on hard mode does not actually spawn more ghasts. Oh, okay. Now let's see, did we get any ghast tears? Okay, that's a bit very too close to the lava there. Might have burnt up somewhere in the lava, I'm not sure. Maybe did not drop anything, because not all ghasts drop stuff, so. Oh, there are though some XP points down there. Okay, now that's a bit of a steep decline there, so I think I'll place some torches to denote that I've been here before, just for my protocol. Then I'm gonna mine down the staircase down there, just so I can get back up. Okay, now get some netherrack, place some down there, jump down, and then create some more. Okay, now, did we get any... Oh, yeah. We got a second gas tier. That's quite epic. Wow. Yeah, we're really getting with the gas tiers. Actually, one thing with the Nether is that the only thing that we need in the Nether is kind of finding Nether fortresses, and that's why I also have to find many, many Nether fortresses. So, Nether will be a big thing for me, and I will be just running around in the Nether many times to find more Nether fortresses, because Nether fortresses give me diamonds, and that's the only access to diamonds and, like, things that are non-renewable that can't be otherwise accessed in the Superflat world. Okay, let me just extinguish that real quick. And now we can go up and fight some of the mobs up there. So, okay, I can already see a wither skeleton spawning there. I really hope this episode is not too long, because I think it's a bit lengthy. But this is a very fun episode for me, at least, because I get to finally go to the Nether. And I can finally get supplies from the Nether. I can finally get some potioning going, so... Okay, so this is kind of a steep descent there. Okay, so we got a little balcony over here, and wow, look at the view. And we died. Now, I don't think we had too much important things on us, but we did kind of get cornered. I did not expect the wither skeleton to come up to us, and let's just go and check that out. Okay, let me take the sword from here real quick. Take some netherrack just in case. And I do actually think that we can get there in the 5-minute limit before all of our stuff despawns. This is something that happens to me very often in the Nether. I get killed in a Nether fortress or something like that, and I have to run back and get my stuff. On the bright side, I wouldn't say that I had too many valuables with me. I mean, I did have, though, a lot of armor, which kind of I'm afraid to lose, but most of it did burn up in the lava, and I did see most of my stuff go down to the abyss of the lava, so I won't expect much from that. Yeah, unfortunately, we did kind of mess up on that. I did not really have much control. I tried kind of running, but it kind of blocked me. I guess I kind of freaked out, and if I had stayed calm, I would have lived. But then on the other hand, the wither effect would probably wither me down to half a heart, and then I would be vulnerable to attack from ghasts or pigmen or anything like that, so... I guess I would have died anyway. Yes, I really hate these wither skeletons. But then on the other hand, I really like them because... they can give me wither skeleton skulls, or wither skeleton heads, which I can use for making a real wither, which I can use to get a nether star, which are really great for beacons, as most Minecraft players know, so. I think that once I get my stuff, that's when this episode is going to be over. I don't want to make it too long, because... I think it has been long enough. I have a sense or feeling of time that when an episode is too long or too short, and I really should have gotten some food with me, because I might starve pretty soon, and we all know what happens when we starve in hard mode in Minecraft. You can die from that, so. Well, we have, I think, gotten to the Nether Fortress within the 5-minute limit, but the most important question is how much of our stuff actually survived. So, I'll have to go and check that out. Actually, one thing that I forgot is I should have brought with me some chests and doors for the base, but I was just too... I was rushing very quickly, so I can make sure that I can get there... I can get here in time to get my stuff before it despawns. Okay, now, well, at least there's a few torches there. Okay, I really hope that my bread did not fall over the edge. Yeah, I did not expect that. I would kind of say that I'm a bit of a crappy Minecraft player because I was unable to deter it from doing that. Now I think I'll have to craft a sword real quick. Grab some wooden doors. I have no idea how it ambushed me like that. I guess on hard mode, they just kind of kill me very quickly, so. Yeah, that's that. And I have no idea how I got killed so quickly, even though I had completely no, I mean, the first time when I got killed very quickly, even though I had iron armor on, so that's kind of a mystery to me. Yeah, we're not all doing too well in the Nether, but that's what the Nether is for. The Nether is an unforgiving place. The Nether is a place where no matter the gear, you can a good day can turn into a bad day anytime. So that's that. I'm very pissed off that I probably lost my items and gonna lose them. I really should have expected better. I don't know what led me to believe that. I don't know how I got killed so quickly. I have played Minecraft for a very long time. I should be a skilled player. I don't know why, like, I get killed all the time. I don't know why that happens. I did see a bunch of cobblestone laying there. I did see some of my tools survive. I did not actually see my bread survive, but I do have my rotten flesh with me here, so that's not an issue. And then, of course, bread is very easy to make and craft, especially with my new semi-automatic food farm setup with redstone and bone meal. It makes it very easy to make more bread, but things like armor are much harder to get unless I, of course, get an iron farm and get an enchanting table and enchant stuff. Armor is much harder to get, and I really hope that I did not lose that armor. And I don't think it had actually been 5 minutes yet. I think when I come there, I will still have the stuff there, and I think I'm just gonna pile up. I think tower up to make sure that when I oh, I did not even get the poison effect when I ate that. That's very rare. Well, like I said, I'm gonna tower up and then make sure so that the wither skeleton does not kill me again, and then I'm just gonna kind of hit it from there. Let's just hope that it does not kill us again, which then it's gonna suck very much. Oh, darn. Well, I'm fairly sure it's still there. I'm actually kind of surprised that it did not despawn yet, because it's really supposed to despawn in the amount of time that I have actually been out and the distance that I've been. I thought that when I get to the overworld that the mobs are supposed to despawn, but apparently the wither skeleton is kind of still there, so. Okay. Now, we have to be most careful. Okay, there we go. It's right there. Okay. Oh, finally. Okay, we do have that wither effect, but looks like it kind of. Are there any dangerous mobs here? Let's collect our stuff before it despawns. And oh crap, I thought I was gonna fall down there. And okay, we still have some more stuff here. Okay, maybe there's some more stuff here. And now let's get the heck out of here. Wow, most of all of my stuff survived. That's a miracle. Okay, now I'm gonna go back and then go back down and then place all of my stuff back in the base. Also, one noob thing I did one time when I staircased up, as I accidentally ran too fast and I actually kind of failed to jump correctly, so that one time I died because of that. And I guess thank you very much for watching this episode. It was fairly fun. It was challenging. In the next episode, we'll find those blaze spawners and farm some blazes. We're gonna start to do potion making, stuff like that. Everything that comes with finding another fortress. Thank you very much for watching. This is Minecraft. See you all in the next video.